And a good Thursday evening to you. 2K Sports presents the NBA. Hi, everyone. This is Kevin Harlan with Chris Webber and Greg Anthony, and our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. Western Conference battles always fun. This time, it's the Los Angeles Lakers intent on protecting home court. Last time they came together was in Minnesota, where they fell to the Wolves. That game brought the season series to 2-1. Now the series finale, looking to draw even to a piece.
And they'll want to show that they're a much better team than they demonstrated last time out against these guys. At the very least, avoid another blowout.
Oh, yeah. Wasn't that a sloppy effort? I mean, turnovers were a huge issue. Now, they don't have to play safe tonight, but they do have to play smart.
And checking out Minnesota's opening lineup. Gibson plays the four with Towns in the middle. Then there's Teague. Then it's Wiggins, Towns. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague. Towns has got the first points on the scoreboard for the Timberwolves. Outside Rondo. There's the dish to Ingram. Here's Chandler. Here's Kuzma, and there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting two. And Minnesota gets called for the foul.
Two shots, gentlemen. Two.
And there were a lot of hidden gems, Chris, in that 2017 draft, and Kyle Kuzma is right at the top of the list.
Well, Kuzma was taken with the 27th overall pick, but he looked like a top five pick, if you ask me. He probably was dissed for being a three-year player at Utah, but that time in college allowed him to hone his skill set.
I mean,
he came into the league with a wide variety of very polished moves.
That one is off.
Yeah, and for being the 27th pick in the 2017 draft, Kuzma has made his mark early, already surpassed expectations.
He doesn't get the second one. Chris, looking at the year so far, teams that made big changes in the offseason starting to develop now some chemistry.
Well, it takes some time, especially if the acquisitions are on the younger side. And this is where great coaching can make all the difference. This is where a great basketball culture in the locker room can make all the difference. It's all about, we say chemistry, chemistry, chemistry. What does that mean? It means trust. It takes time to build trust. It takes time to understand your players and what they like, where to get them the ball, what makes them better. And once you get to that point, it's a liberating feeling because now you feel like, okay, guys, we've gotten through the murky waters. Now we can have some fun. We know who we are. We have an identity. Let's go out and do this.
Pass to Ingram. And stolen by Wiggins. Inside. That's his second shot and his second basket. He's 2 for 2.
Yeah, good awareness there. He sees an opening and doesn't hesitate.
Well, that opening right there, that's just because the defense failed to rotate.
Now here's Ingram. 17 points in his last outing. And no good. Towns with the defensive effort.
And the cold start gets a little colder. Just 1 for 4 to start the game.
Nice ball movement by Minnesota. 11 feet away, and again it's Minnesota.
Nice way to start the evening. His number's getting called, and for good reason.
Well, yeah, he's a guy who can carry you for stretches, long stretches in this game. You want to get him involved early and often.
Now, here's Kuzma. He's coming off a 16-point game against Golden State. Shot clock at 5. Rondo gets the bucket.
If he's one thing, he's efficient in the paint. Rondo really good with the positioning there close to the basket.
Towns, the pass to Wiggins.
Who's watching him?
Outside, Towns feeds it to Gibson. Shoots over Kuzma, and the shot is long. Lakers trail by 4, and let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Tom Thibodeau had a few minutes to share. He said that one problem with this team is the shot blocking. He said, we've got to play unselfishly, make the extra pass to punish defenders for rotating over, and above all, we have to remain aggressive and continue to attack. Kevin?
David, thanks. Sounds like he's prepped his guys on how to handle this opposing defense.
And no surprise there, because they're facing a team that can win games with its defense. They are an aggressive bunch from the start.
Well, look, you can play with pace, you can play with speed, and still be patient. And that's what this team is going to have to do against this aggressive D. They can't force things. They've got to play smart and in control.
Now Rondo. Jeff Teague missing from long range. Kuzma kicks to Ingram. Off target from outside.
And he's been way off the mark this quarter. It's been ugly.
Chandler with the rebound.
They hold the early advantage on the glass.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Here's Caldwell Pope, and he banks in the layup. Caldwell Pope's got his first bucket in this one.
And the versatility of Caldwell Pope, not just the score from outside, but also a threat to shoot the ball close to the hoop as well.
5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Passes it to Wiggins. Off the mark, and the drop continues. Ingram outside. Here's Rondo. That misses, had a chance to tie it there. He doesn't hit that one. One quarter in the books, and it's been a close one so far. Timberwolves lead by two. And back with the start of the second quarter in just a moment. All-star big man Karl Anthony Towns is hungry to maximize his potential.
I want to be the best player who ever played, and I feel that I could do that. I think I have the God-given talent and the God-given abilities to make it happen, and I have total confidence in myself every single day. I wake up that I could be the greatest player who ever played. I know if I continue to put the work ethic in and continue to do all the little things I need to do, I could find myself in that conversation. But, you know, obviously I got to learn every single day and never take no days for granted.
On his coaches, Greg, and teammates love hearing that.
And how can you not? I mean, that kind of drive is special. And with his tools and potential, hard to put a ceiling on just how good he can be.
And this has been a fairly close game through the first quarter, and we'll see what happens here in the second. And guys, what's your take so far in the Timberwolves?
Hustling on that offensive glass, that's led to a number of second chance points.
Well, obviously that was the game plan coming in. Be physical right off the rip.
And so in the game for the Timberwolves, Charge is out there with Jang, then it's Jared Bayless, then it's Rose, and it's Wiggins in at the threesome. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. Chris, do you think hustle is a skill? And if you do, or want to even tackle that, who are some of the guys that you think hustle is as much as any players in the league?
Not only is hustle a skill, but your motor and hustle is the most underrated skill in basketball, I believe. Think about Draymond Green's impact in Oakland.
Yes.
What he's done for that team. How about a Patrick Beverley, a Marcus Smart, a Kawhi Leonard? These guys definitely can change the pace of the game, especially in the playoffs where every possession matters and the fans are hung on every movement that you do. The fans are waiting and anticipating every play, and all they want is someone to do something so they can get up and get excited. Well, nothing gets the crowd more excited than diving on the floor, saving a possession for your team, you getting a layup on the other end, and these are the guys I would bet first that would make a play like that happen.
Skill indeed. Good point. Now, here's Stevenson. And right now, he's averaging about 7 points a game. Kicks it out to Beasley. And he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. It's going to be on Šarić. The Lakers have missed both free throws they've attempted tonight.
And the season numbers for them at the line thus far are really poor. Something I'm sure they are making a point of emphasis.
Two shots.
The first one falls. He hits one and misses one, each at the line. Timberwolves leading by five. Rose surveying the D. Here's Wiggins. Busts the J after the cagey pass fake. Well, it was the Los Angeles Lakers in their last game, a loss to Golden State.
And the big problem, they got trigger happy. Shot a very low percentage from beyond the arc.
Well, the obvious solve is to go to the basket. I mean, there were some open lanes. They were just unwilling to take advantage of it.
From outside the arc, shot clock reset for the Lakers. A second chance effort. Outside for Rondo. Launches it. Sinks the three-pointer. Rondo's got five.
And every now and then, Rondo will surprise you with the occasional triple, showing it off there with range.
Now here's Wiggins. A 17-point game for him in the win against Phoenix. Jang, no luck.
You can't be missing shots like that in the post. That'll get you a spot on the bench.
To the left side wing. Here's Hart. He is still scoreless so far in this one. Pass to Beasley. Over Šarić. Misses off the right iron. Timberwolves leading by four. Over Beasley. The step back jumper is good.
How about that move? You'll see very few players able to pull off. Just sensational stuff.
So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles.
Yeah, you know, some of it's shot selection, some just bad luck, and they just can't get anything going.
Well, this is the dilemma as a coach. You wonder, do I need to call a timeout here? Do I need to settle these guys down? Should I let them play through it?
And some changes here for the Lakers. JaVale McGee's checked in for Zubats. Kyle Kuzma comes in for Michael Beasley. And it's Kentavious Caldwell-Pope in for Rajon Rondo. Offensive rebound. Stevenson finds Caldwell-Pope. Can't cash in on the 10-foot jumper. Minnesota leading by six. And here is Bayless. A 14-point game for him in the win against the Suns in Phoenix.
Well, he also made a mark with his passing and had the assist total to show for it.
Now here's Rose, and that one is good. Rose has got his first basket of the night.
And you love to see Rose aggressively looking to score on the inside.
Hart kicks to Stevenson. To the inside, Caldwell Pope. That ball, nice feed that time from Stevenson.
I like that pick play. I mean, you can see how easily it makes it for him to get to the cup. Look, Caldwell Pope, Kevin, he's one of the better 3-and-D wings in this league. He's very active with his hands. And on defense, you know he's always going to get a handful of steals. But he's not the most efficient scorer. But he's solid from deep.
Goes up the baseline. Towns, no luck.
Pretty high percentage look with the D playing off. Just couldn't knock it down.
Snatched up. That's tipped. There's 47 seconds left in the first half. Back to Šarić. Okogie. He's guarded by Caldwell Pope. McGee with the block. 2-on-1 as they jump out on the break. Pull up jumper. Hart, no good. Timberwolves leading by six. Šarić dishes to Bayless. 2 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Here's Hart. And the rejection by Towns.
And his foot movement is what makes Towns such a terrific shot blocker. He moves so well and can defend just about any position on the floor.
Drilled it right as the clock hit all zeros.
Wow, what a clutch shot. He's got nerves of steel.
Woo! And guts to match. That's how you rise to the occasion, fellas.
And so it's the Minnesota Timberwolves. With a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter, they have made it very tough to get a shot off against them. Their defense has been stifling. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Carl Anthony Towns. An impressive first half and a nice start for you guys. How did that happen?
I mean, yeah, we had some great days of practice. You know, this is what happens when you got some days off.
Got the spring in your step again. Thanks, Carl Anthony. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to 2K Sports, the Halftime Show. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. Boy, we have a lot to discuss. It was a closely contested first quarter for Minnesota. At the end of the period, they held a 2-point lead. For the Timberwolves, Kenny, what's your take?
Well, they showed a lot of discipline on offense, called some high percentage plays. Even when the defense devised different looks, they always seem to have the answer. That's good coaching.
Shaq, your take on the Lakers?
Well, they're just not creating enough scoring opportunities, and they're pretty lucky they're not trailing by 15 right now. They need to play more unselfishly, work for better spacing, go stronger to the basket.
And that'll do it for us. The third quarter about to begin with Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll catch you on the flip side.
My brother.
Second half of basketball upon us. We may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game it's been so far. Carl Anthony Towns with a strong contribution so far in this one.
Well, they've done a good job of letting the game come to them, and really few forced shots here so far.
Terrific first half on offense. This is how you draw it up. We'll see if they can maintain that efficiency going forward.
And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball. Taking a look at the Lakers. Ingram and Kuzma filling up the three and the four. Rondo and Caldwell Pope in the backcourt. And it's Chandler in at the five, roaming the paint. Rondo with the ball, picked up by Teague. And it's Ingram missing. Minnesota leading by six. Here's Wiggins, uses the glass to finish the layup. Wiggins has got the first points to start out the third quarter for the Timberwolves. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Nice, and you can't forget about the bunnies on Caldwell Pope. I mean, this guy is definitely looking to slam it down whenever he gets an opportunity.
Kicks it to Towns, over Chandler. Towns, no luck. The Lakers shooting terribly up to this point, just 30%. Some ramshackle offense play there. Buries the long-range jumper. When it comes to video review, C-Web, do you feel the NBA has done a good job of incorporating it into the flow of the game, or is there, in your opinion, still some work to be done in this regard?
There's a little work to be done. I mean, nothing's ever perfect, but I think they've done a great job. I mean, you want to get it right, and so there's going to be a little bit of an inconvenience sometimes in going back to it, but the main thing for me is to make sure that it is as fast as possible, that you're not giving the team extra time to get together and to huddle up and to call plays. You're not taking the rhythm away from a team that just went on a 10-0 run, and now they have to sit on the side for 2 minutes in real time and see if this call is correct. So the speed that is done with the video review is the only thing I think that needs to be worked on, and that's going to be situation to situation. So I think the NBA is doing a really good job.
Good points. And that one falls for Ingram. C-Web, usually rookies take more threes as they grow in the NBA. That has not been the case for Brandon Ingram.
Well, Ingram went the opposite way, taking less threes. If you think about it, he focused more on slashing and mid-range shots, and I think it's worked for him. He settled less, and he took a big step forward in his offensive development because of it.
So he gets them both.
Yeah, and the second pick in the 2016 draft out of Duke, bro, Brandon Ingram, possessing a rare combination of length and shooting ability.
Outside Rose. Over Ingram. Rose can't hit. And so it's Rondo bringing it up for Los Angeles. It's a three-point game. They get it back. Kuzma can't get it to go.
That's just a quick move to the 10 and an even quicker reaction by the D to stop him there.
Outside Rose. In the corner, it's Wiggins. Goes up on the wing. It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
As off the mark as he has been, they're a little lucky to be in front.
And that one's good. Ingram. And
Ingram flowing into his jump shot. That's tough to guard.
Timberwolves have gone 2 of 6 from the field here in the third. Rose with the ball. Now guarded by Ingram. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. Kuzma against Rose. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
And unfortunately, injuries will always be the concern with Derrick Rose. Still loves the game of basketball, knows he is limited compared to what he once was. Amazing with all he's fought through, he can still perform at such a high level.
Two shots.
No good on the free throw. And with Rose, as you said, his love of the game is still there. And he still wants to play.
I mean, many players would have just walked away from having their body betray him. But Rose said last season he loves what he gets to do and still would be a water boy if he had to. You have to admire Rose's attitude and approach in that regard.
And that trip coming up empty, missing both.
Not what you expect out of him. He was doing it cool off a little, I guess.
And the slam dunk by McGee. And the Lakers lead by one.
Now those passes into the paint have to be precise, just like that one.
And a tremendous Unleash Chaos replay coming to you courtesy of Under Armour Hover Havoc. Teague for three, bangs home the trifecta. Teague's got 5 points now in the quarter.
And you could tell Teague was looking for a shot on that play. Always had his hands up, ready to catch and fire.
Here's Stevenson. Rebound by Jang.
I'll give him that shot again. He'll probably hit it. That's a good look.
Wiggins passes to Rose. That falls. Nice feed that time from Wiggins.
And how about the airtime improvisation from Derrick Rose? Able to hang and finish with a defender looming.
Stevenson against Wiggins. From the stripe. Up again. Controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Oh, great timing. He is one tough customer on that offensive glass.
You know, it's like he has a sixth sense of where that rebound is going. Back to Jang. Outside Rose. Stolen away. Out of bounds. Minnesota takes possession. Some changes for the Lakers. Chandler comes in for Ivica Zubac. And it's Caldwell Pope in for Ingram. And the Timberwolves making a change here. We've got 28 seconds left in the third quarter. Outside Rose. Six to shoot. Offline with the baseline jumper. Got it!
No.
Got it! What a
Come
shot!
On. No way.
Oh, incredible buzzer beater there, guys. This crowd is going wild.
We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feed.
I mean, well, if you're the coaching staff, I mean, you're pumped up. This highlight will not only make it on the TV, it'll make it into the film session tomorrow.
Well, this has been a great contest so far, and I imagine the fourth quarter could have even more action in store for us. And a look at the five for the Timberwolves to start the fourth. They've got Šarić. Rose is out there with Jared Bayless. Then there's Towns.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Timberwolves trail by four. Rose kicks to Bayless. Okogie doesn't go for him. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Next matchup, they'll be home against the Suns. And that'll be the third of the four straight at home. Stevenson outside. Six to shoot. On its way from Caldwell Pope for two. And the Lakers tack on two more.
And offensively, they finally seem to be coming around after an ugly first half.
Now here's Rose. Defense right on him. And there's the pass to Towns. Now here's Bayless. He's guarded by Caldwell Pope. There's Rose with the three. Rebounded by the Lakers. Great offensive performance they're putting on.
And guys, we call that the zone because that's where they are right now. They are in a zone, and I'm sure they feel unstoppable.
Caldwell Pope kicks to Hart. Towns with the defensive effort.
Oh, it's been a rough game for him, but it won't sting too bad as long as they hang on to the lead.
It's tipped. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Here's Hart. Pass to McGee. And the rejection by Towns. Minnesota calls timeout. And Jadavious Caldwell-Pope really making a difference here.
Wow, it's time for them to switch up their defense though, because what they've been doing so far is not working.
Some changes here for the Lakers. Kyle Kuzma's checked in for JaVale McGee. Brandon Ingram comes in for Lance Stephenson. Rajon Rondo subbed in for Josh Hart. Timberwolves also changing it up. Taj Gibson's checked in for Šarić, and Wiggins is subbed in for Jared Bayless. Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin. Well, during the break, I heard Tom Thibodeau as he talked with the team. He said, guys, we look like we're running in mud. Let's get out and see the early offense. And if it's not there, let's run the half-court offense. Pretty good advice, Kevin.
All right, David, thanks. Just four to shoot. Here's Rondo. The teardrop falls in. Rondo's got the lead up to eight now for Los Angeles.
And there's nobody any better in terms of running the pick and roll than Rondo. He's ready to shoot
as soon as he comes off the screen.
Here's Towns. Over Chandler. And it's Towns missing for Los Angeles. They've gotten four of their six shots to fall so far here in the fourth. A pretty nice efficiency there. Caldwell Pope kicks to Ingram. And it's Rondo in the corner. Lakers passing it around. Watch it fly. And again, it's the Lakers.
And it's been about that execution offensively. I mean, they have been superb.
Yeah, and it's been a team game, a number of contributions. Guys staying focused. That's why the lead continues to grow.
Ingram outside. Rondo kicks to Caldwell Pope. Ingram outside. Over Gibson. Shot clock reset for the Lakers. Chandler, no good. And so it's Wiggins with it. He'll bring it up for Minnesota. Trailing by 10. To the left wing. Okogie. He's covered by Ingram. Okogie. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires.
And just enough wiggle room to get off his shot.
Well, when you're at a size disadvantage, sometimes the mid-range is better than inside. You get a little more space. You don't allow the shot blocker to get up on you. And also, you can use your handles and your quickness.
I'll tell you what, the energy in this arena, you can feel it.
Well, a well-earned victory, feeding off the energy of this hometown crowd really all night.
Minnesota calls timeout. They're trailing by 10. 23 seconds left in the game. What's your take, guys?
Yeah, this has been rough all the way around. I mean, coming in with high hopes and then just now trying to finish the best they can.
All you can do at this point is focus. Dial in on each moment. Do your best. You can't get consumed over the score.
The presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope.
And his percentage from the field tonight seemed almost made up. I didn't think it was possible to have that kind of success shooting the basketball. You need a little bit of luck, a bunch of hard work, and a whole lot of talent.
Williams finds Bayless. Stolen by Caldwell Pope. Passes to Rondo. So it's Los Angeles winning this one easily. A confident win and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
Yeah, I mean, it was a solid performance, particularly here at home. And I think they built off that edge of being here and playing with just a little more confidence than their opponent.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Chris Weber, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching the NBA presented by 2K Sports. And we'll see you next time.